Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off this video, Elon Musk posted a tweet on Thursday of Starlink is designed for low to medium population density, which means we can hit max users in some areas fast. Please sign up early to ensure a spot. As more satellites roll out, SpaceX will be able to serve more. Somebody else posted a tweet about Starlink with Starlink beta is ending this month as stated. Will we see more of the southern states, Louisiana, Texas, etc. rollouts? Musk responded and said should be nationwide rollout by end of month. Note, still limited by peak number of users in same area. This will improve as more satellites are launched. NASA posted a tweet about SpaceX's next Dragon capsule name. It says we have a capsule name. Rajachari announces the SpaceX Dragon capsule has been named Endurance by Crew 3. Teslarati posted a tweet about an article saying SpaceX reveals plans to double fleet of reusable Dragon spacecraft in less than 9 months. Musk responded with, it's a big deal that Dragon is reusable with improved refurbishment efficiency with each passing flight. This is not the case for other orbital spacecraft. It means the space fleet grows every time a new Dragon is made. Eric Berger posted a tweet about upcoming crew missions and astronauts. He said, NASA update now includes information on Jeanette Epps. She will remain assigned to NASA's Boeing Starliner 1, but is cross-training with the team on the Crew Dragon system. My understanding is that if no Russian flies on Crew 5, Epps will get that seat. CNBC posted an article about SpaceX's valuation increasing. It says SpaceX has an agreement with new and existing investors to sell up to $755 million in stock from insiders at $560 a share, according to multiple people familiar with the deal, increasing the company's valuation to $100.3 billion. Heading over to the Boca Chica action, the new red structure is to assist with the catching arm installation. The carriage system for the chopstick catching arms was lifted. It was then placed on the red stand. One of the catching arms was also lifted next to the carriage structure. Work is being done to enclose the newly built stairs at Starbase. Another large propellant tank was delivered to Boca Chica. The foundation work for the new wider high bay is continuing. The ground support equipment tank GSE-8 was rolled out to the launch site. The tank was then lifted into place at the orbital tank farm. Ship 20 continues to be worked on in preparation for further testing. Taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, we can hopefully expect testing this coming week. There is a closure currently scheduled for Tuesday, October 12th, Wednesday and Thursday. The Ship 21 nose and nose cone barrel section is progressing. There is a hybrid booster test tank recently stacked in the mid bay. The booster 5 upper section was recently stacked in the high bay. To finish up our Sunday video, we once again have the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. Ship 21 and Booster 5 are coming together nicely. There's also a new test tank B2.1 stacked in the mid bay. Once again, thanks to Mary or Boca Chica Gal for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to Nick Ansuini who has also been out there quite a lot recently filming the Starbase content. As always, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.